Corey Stewart, thank you very much for talking with us.
My pleasure.
So how do you think the debate went?
Well, I thought it went great. I wanted to expose the fact that Tim Kaine has gotten nothing done in the United States Senate, or even when he was governor. So that's 10 years where he's been representing Virginia. He's gotten nothing done. And I think Virginians, whether they're Republicans or Democrats or independents, they have to ask this question. What has Tim Kaine done? And the answer is very, very, very little. And we can't afford that anymore in Virginia.
Of course, he disagrees with that. He argues that he's worked on a number of issues, both as governor and in the Senate. How much of a challenge is it for you, coming as someone who is, you're in charge of county government, but you haven't held statewide office, to be coming in at this point, challenging an incumbent in a state that went, 6 points for Hillary Clinton?
Well, you've got to remember that Prince William County really is a microcosm, not just of Virginia, but of America. It's one of the largest counties in the United States. It's the second largest locality in Virginia. It's very diverse. It's very fast growing. It's very dynamic. And governing a county of that size successfully, increasing its economy, growing the economy in Virginia and in Prince William County, we've got a 3% unemployment rate. I've brought down crime. I've been able to build our own highways because the state failed to do so. So I've done a very, very good job of managing and governing one of the largest, most diverse, most dynamic localities in the country.
A lot of this debate, and through much of it, President Trump's name came up. You made it very clear you agree with him on so many issues. Is there anything you disagree with President Trump about?
Well, there are going to be things here and there that I don't agree with. Sure. When he initially came out and said that he was for this travel ban against Muslims, I said, no, that's not right, and I disagreed with him on that. But the current travel ban, it's not based upon religion. So there are going to be things that, I'm not going to agree with him on, and I don't. You're reducing funding for the Chesapeake Bay cleanup. I don't agree with that. But on the big issues, I think the president is doing a great job. And on the number one issue of growing the economy, cutting taxes on businesses, on individuals, and we have this growth, record growth, the lowest unemployment rate since the 1960s, the lowest unemployment rate ever for African Americans and Hispanics, real wages rising for working class Americans. Those are things that we need to support. Tim Kaine doesn't.
You mentioned wages, but this was a question in the debate. Yes, there was a corporate tax cut, but much of that money has gone to profits and to stock buybacks. We're not seeing the wage increases that many thought there would be. How do you explain that? Why should ordinary Americans, ordinary Virginians, support this tax cut when they're not realizing the benefits?
Well, we are seeing the fastest wage growth, real wage growth, in 20 years. And we're only 7 months into this tax cut. The tax cut was just passed in December. Already we're seeing record economic growth, over 4%, approaching 4%. We didn't even approach 3% under President Obama and when Tim Kaine was governing the economy. Now we have you got to remember, the last time we had a major tax cut in 1981, it yielded positive economic results for a couple of decades, and we're just 7 months into the beginning of this one.
Immigration, another major issue. It's something you've been tough on since you first started running in local politics in Virginia. What people, I think, are focused on today is in essence, it's a reversal by the Trump administration. They're now saying families can stay together. They're trying to bring back these children who were separated from their parents. Was that a mistake on the part of the president to say we're going to take these children away?
No, I think that what had happened was, this policy was really started under the Obama administration. It was held over into the Trump administration. I think the president...
There was not a policy of separating children from parents.
What the president did was to enforce immigration laws. Those laws, by the way, they've been there forever. What the president is doing is to send the signal that if you want to come to the United States, you have to do so lawfully. That's the only way it's going to work. If we want to prevent another humanitarian crisis like we did under the Obama administration, when all these children were being sent over here by their parents in the hopes of the American dream, and that's what caused all of these separations in the first place. If we want to stem that and make sure it doesn't happen again, we have to send the right signal that yes, we welcome you into the United States, provided that you come here legally.
But when I described the circumstances around some of these very young children being returned to their parents, hadn't been bathed, covered with lice.
Yes,
when you think about those babies, those children, even older children, is it still worth the policy that you're describing to have had this happen?
Well, we have to be able to do both. We both have to enforce our nation's immigration laws, and at the same time, we have to be humane. I think that the president has found the right balance here. I mean, everybody's hearts are torn out when you see the children in that condition, when they're separated from their parents. It's a terrible, terrible thing. But we also have to recognize that we have to enforce our nation's immigration laws. Otherwise, we're going to continue to have people coming into the country. Most of them are just hardworking people looking for the American dream. But some of them have criminal backgrounds. Some of them are members of MS-13. Some of them are coming into the United States and preying on children, causing crimes. We have to make sure that we keep out criminal illegal aliens.
So you think you can do both? You can have a tough policy and what, treat children how?
Yes. I think you have to have a humane policy, but you have to enforce the nation's laws. The reason we have all these problems, not just with regard to that, but all these criminal problems on both sides of the border with Mexico, is because that we don't have border security. We need a wall, and we need to enforce our immigration laws inside of the United States, yes, through Immigration and Customs Enforcement, which Tim Kaine wants to abolish, and he never denied it today, by the way. And you know, Immigration and Customs Enforcement are removing criminal illegal aliens, including sex traffickers. The last thing we want to do is remove that federal enforcement of our immigration law.
As you know, there's a controversy about some of the individuals you've associated with who've been accused of being anti-Semitic, being white supremacist. Why did you have anything to do with those people in the first place? You said you only learned later that they had these views. But there are other Republicans who chose not to associate with them.
Well, you know, got to remember, I mean, these folks didn't come out with their views. These are heinous views. You know, I completely disavow any sort of racism or bigotry or anti-Semitism. Once I found out that those individuals had those views, I disavowed myself from them. And I want nothing to do with them. But on the other hand, Senator Kaine has completely embraced Leslie Coburn, who is the Democratic nominee for Congress in Virginia's 5th District, who's written a blatantly anti-Semitic book. And Senator Kaine not only has embraced her, but he actually shares an office with her in Charlottesville.
On the question of Roy Moore, you did go to his election night rally in Alabama. Why did you go?
Well, I thought that he was treated unfairly. I don't think it's right. That 40 years after something supposedly happened, somebody comes out and says that you do something. And then, instead of them having to prove that you did it, it was left upon him to try to prove that he didn't do it 40 years later. I just thought that was unfair.
Do you think do you believe him when he says he didn't?
Yeah, I do believe him when he said he didn't
have any sort of relationship with women who were underage, that all those women were lying?
Well, I believe him. What is disturbing about this is that, you know, we believe in this country, we're supposed to believe in this country, that you're innocent until proven guilty. And in that situation, he was just presumed to be guilty 40 years after the supposed fact happened. And I just thought that was wrong.
Last question. Your tone in the debate was pretty tough. Time and again, you used some pretty tough language in describing Senator Kaine. Is that the kind of campaign that you think serves Virginia well?
I think people want to hear the truth, and they don't want us to, they want us to get to the point. Virginians and Americans are so sick and tired of mealy-mouthed politicians who say kind things, who say soft things, but actually mean different things. They want people who are going to be just brutally honest, and that's what I'm going to do during this campaign.
Corey Stewart, thank you very much.
My pleasure.